coming to you live from the WNTHG news station. I'm here with Niels Bohr, a physicist from Denmark in 1885. So, how are you?
Thank you for having me today. I'm doing exceptionally well. I'm glad to be here on behalf of my fellow colleagues to present you the theory about the Bohr model.
That's great. So, what was your school life like?
Well, to be frank with you, I was an extreme troublemaker. That was always up to no good. I procrastinated on everything, did not do my projects, especially the essays. But that was quickly changed when I realized it would not go over too well with teachers. So, who was your chemistry teacher?
Miss Kennedy at Bankstown High School.
You mean she's that old?
Oh my gosh, is that true?
Oh, she's ancient.
Oh wow. I can see that you're a troublemaker, you know? You just seem like that type to be that way. Do you mind telling us where you went to college?
I graduated from the United Kingdom at the University of Cambridge, the Victoria University of Manchester, and the University of Copenhagen in 1911. And 11 years later, voila, I got a Nobel Peace Prize.
Don't get such a big head about that, but that is impressive, I admit. Wait, if you were born in the 1800s, how do you look so young?
Cryogenic freezing. It was cold. I even think I got a little frostbite still on my toe.
It must have been wonderful to just wake up in the 21st century without even having to wait all those years.
You guys sure are far behind. What we expected you guys to be at through the years would have been flying cars, robot butlers, everything would have been done for you. You guys don't even have a single building on the moon. Oh, don't get me started about the economy and what you guys have done to the environment. You guys are still even using manual teleprompters.
Okay, I can get the environment, but don't start on the economy, okay? Moving on. If I remember correctly, your theory was about atoms based on Millikan's theory, correct?
Not completely. It was actually based off of Rutherford's theory. He mainly got it incorrect because he thought that the electrons were still stationary.
Interesting. I'm sorry, but my sources must have been momentarily incorrect. The signal must have been interfered with because of the football game. They say that Millikan got a touchdown, so I misunderstood them. So, did you make a model of your theory?
Yes, I did. It was called the Bohr theory model. Named after me, but it was also called the planetary model because I thought that the electrons orbited around the core in a constant motion. Oh, I figured you guys would at least fixed the signal problems. We always heard of you guys having perfect signal.
I don't think that's true. You're a very honest person, aren't you? How do you feel about being disproved? It's happened, what, 10 times already?
I've always tried to be honest. But hey, if you don't say your feelings, you'd be stuck in a boring class. It's not the best of feelings to be disproved. But I'm glad that I was disproved to make science more accurate.
Well, that's great, and it's also very true. So was it like to have studied under Rutherford and be there while he actually practiced his own atomic theory?
I learned a lot and got a great experience. Our entire class did, I believe. He fired helium nuclei at the piece of gold foil, which was only about a few atoms thick. When atoms were fired at it, the foil only... He collected a few, and about 1 in 10,000. The number we came up with. The other either bounced off or passed through.
Wow, I'm sure that the results were fascinating, probably anticlimactic. So do you think you can tell us a little more about your model?
Yes, I could. First, the electrons only travel in specific orbits at a certain distance, set of distances, from the nucleus with specific energies. Second, the electrons do not continuously lose energy as they travel. They can only gain and lose energy by jumping from one allowed orbit to another, absorbing the emitting electromagnetic radiation.
Oh my goodness, that is a lot to take in.
Not for the time I took. After a long time.
Obviously. Well, that's all the time we have. Hope you have a good sleep, Mr. Bohr. It's time to get back into the freezer. We'll see you next time on WNTHG.